We'll see you guys soon. Great job. And we're done. Nice job!
Harbor Talk!
That's Harbor Talk.
Welcome to Harbor Talk. Each week, I bring on a guest to safely talk about three taboo topics in 3 minutes. Before the show, I cook the guest breakfast. After the show, the guest and I talk about the topics they chose in depth. This week's guest is my mom, Kim Harbor. Mom!
Luke!
Are you ready to do some Harbor Talk?
Ready to do some Harbor Talk. I'm ready to go.
Okay, we are starting the timer in 3, 2, 1, begin. So what is the first thing you'd like to talk about today?
Well, I'd like to talk about the taboo messages around being pregnant and getting pregnant.
Okay. Well, tell me, why do you feel that pregnancy is a taboo topic?
Well, I don't think pregnancy itself is a taboo topic, but I think there is some information about when you are so elated, you know, when someone gets pregnant and how exciting that is, especially if it's your first child. Well, any child, actually, it's very exciting. All children that are born, it's exciting. But they don't talk about the things that might happen or the things that might be disappointing or the things that might be difficult in a normal, what we call pregnancy, not a high-risk pregnancy, just a normal 9-month, you know, full-term baby pregnancy. Okay. And I think that that's just always kind of wrapped up in a little nice bow.
For sure.
And it isn't that way, because when our first child, before our first child was born, I had a miscarriage. And that was never talked about the high possibility of miscarriage. And it is, it's high in pregnancies in general, but they don't talk about it until it happens. And it's very devastating. It's very difficult. Then when you deliver the child, the lovely little child, it's painful. It's very hard on your body. They don't talk about how your bottom hurts. My bottom hurt for a long time. They never talk about that. And the sort of true of what's really, really going to happen. It's all a little magnified and glorified, and it really is somewhat terrifying.
Okay, well, thank you very much for your opinion on that. Well, tell me about your second taboo topic, which is the college admission process or real life after college, correct?
So I think there's an issue with the presentation of going to college and graduating from college. So everyone, you know, goes to college and hopefully they have a wonderful experience. And if they are work hard and they graduate, you know, and you get that diploma and it's an exciting day, I don't think there's a lot of discussion about what is realistically next, especially if you're in a type of a major that isn't an immediate placement, like you're not going to med school or you're going on to become a lawyer or some of those things, which are just kind of thrown out there in the world of trying to get a job. I don't think they actually prepare individuals for that very well.
Yeah.
And I think the college admissions and the college system needs to do a much better job about launching these young people realistically after they graduate.
Sure. Okay. And then the last topic that you want to talk about today, what would that be?
So the last topic that we want to talk about today is raising kind of an unusual child.
Okay.
You know, and I think we have to be careful about the words unusual, abnormal, weird, different. Mm-hmm. I never looked at it that way as a parent, because society has labeled what they think is normal. But for me, when I've raised two boys to young men. You know, Cole is almost 25. You'll be 24 in July.
Cole's my brother, by the way.
Cole is Luke's brother. And I've always embraced who they were, and they are very different from each other. And I've tried to go down that parental journey with them so that they then could become their true authentic self. But not every parent is open to that. They have this thing in their mind about how they want that kid to be and where that kid should go to school and how that kid should behave. And they have this pre-plan for them. And I think that's the biggest mistake that a parent can make. I think you have to embrace who your child is. We all have gifts. I say that all the time. Our gifts are different. You have to explore what your gifts are and let the child explore what their gifts are, and then they become who they truly are, and you don't push that down of who they are.
Right.
So for me, it was a joy to raise an unusual child. And really, both of my kids are kind of unusual in their own ways. And maybe we're all unusual.
I think we hide it. I think a lot of people hide how strange they are.
We're all so unusual. True. My mother would probably say she raised an unusual daughter, which would be me.
Sure.
So maybe we should just say that we are all kind of unusual and that's okay.
Yeah.
But we should embrace that and not put our arm up against it.
Beautiful way of putting it. Well, the timer went back a while ago, but I think to say the least that this has been a lovely extended conversation. Good job.
Thanks, Luke.
Welcome. Thank you all very much for watching Harbor Talk today. Feel free to submit your taboo topic to my Instagram account. She had to pick two taboo topics from you, so feel free to do that. Mom, are you ready to do the... are you ready to do the outro?
I'm going to try really hard. Here we go.
Okay, ready?
Pause, play,
try to be kind,
and keep making a difference.
We'll see you guys soon.